Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, great question from Richard. Great because it has several different ways to solve it, some of which are fairly geeky and fairly tough. Richard has a pivot table, and basically, he has different reason codes down the side and different branches going across the top. And you'll see that here in Q1, there were three different reasons. And so, the grand total is in row 8. As he switches to Q2, though, there were more reasons. So, the grand total is in 10, and in Q3, there are different number of reasons, so the total is in 9. He wanted to write a formula out here that's going to always show the percentage of the total. Now, he only wanted it for the grand total. That's why he didn't build it as part of the pivot table. And so, of course, the problem that you have is if you use equal G5 divided by G9, well, that G9 is going to change every time. And so, there's a really cool use of VLOOKUP. Not the VLOOKUP that most of us use with the comma false at the end, but the other version of VLOOKUP. If we use equal VLOOKUP, and we look up some large number, so I'm just going to search for 99999 within the range, column G, first column, and then put comma true at the end instead of comma false. Now, you can actually leave comma true out. This is an amazing version of VLOOKUP that basically is going to give us the last numeric item in the table. Not the largest, but the last. Now, it happens in this case that the grand total is probably going to be the largest, so we could have used max. But I like this VLOOKUP because it's a very clever way to go, just looking for some number larger than any number you could possibly want, and it's going to return that last value. And just by way of example, if I would put, for example, a 17 here, that formula over here is going to return a 17. So, very clever little formula. So, one solution for Richard is to build a formula that says, hey, we're going to take equal G5 divided by the VLOOKUP of some large number within this range, large range of column G, comma 1, comma true, and that'll show that that particular reason was 11%. And I want to copy this down through several cells. We will get the percentage of the total, and we will find as you go through and choose a different quarter, Q1, it is still dividing by the right number instead of some other number. So, very cool solution. Now, if you want to avoid this entirely, a different solution is to come here to the reason code. I'm going to double click on reason, and there's a setting here called show items with no data. And what this is going to do is make sure that all 5 reasons show up every single quarter. So, even if there was no data for one of those reasons, it will show up. Now, we can always predictably know that the grand total is going to be in row 10, and we could solve the problem in that way. So, a couple of different solutions, and also, assuming there were no negatives, which in this case, since it's a count, there wouldn't have been. We could have also used the max of column G to return the largest value. Couple of different solutions to Rich's problem of how to make sure that that percentage of total over here is always dividing by the correct number returned from the pivot table. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.